Hey everybody, it's Mike and Denise, and we wanted to give an update with this Model Y that we've had for about almost a week now, and put probably close to 1,000 miles on it. And we're used to driving it with the Model X, which I've had since 2017, and the one you can buy now is pretty much the same in terms of body size. It's the exact same body, although the motors and other things are different on it. But this one also is pretty much the same what you can buy right now, even though this one's a 2022, it's got over 100,000 miles on it. Ours, of course, is about 300,000 miles on it, and it's a 2017, but they're both current, basically, other than a few extra features here and there that you can get. So we're gonna compare the size and the usability and the drivability, the ride, all these things, because we've lived out of both cars now, so we can give you a pretty good idea as to the differences. Now, right away, I'll tell you, when we first got the car, I noticed when I opened up the hatch in the back, I was banging my head into the top of the hatch because I noticed I was always used to a certain level, and the Model X is tall enough for me. I'm almost 6'2", and I'm a little taller with these shoes on. I was never banging my head, but I banged my head several times the first day. Okay, just walking under that door in the back of the hatch.
I'm 5'10", so I do not bang my head. So if you're 5'10" or below, that doesn't matter for you.
Okay, yeah. And let's see, then also this is the bigger tires and rims like ours does. This is like 21s, I think. Ours has 22s, but it's the same, like more performance tire, but non-performance vehicle. I don't have the Performance X, this is not the Performance Y, but they're both dual motor regular. So it's a very comparable in terms of the power and the ride. All right, now this has no air suspension where the Model X has air suspension. I noticed right away the ride was harsher.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, right away, because you complained before about our Model X being too harsh.
Yeah, because you have those low profile rims on it.
Well, same as here.
Your Model X rides better when you've got the fluffier tires on it.
Right, but we're comparing apples to apples. So we got low profile tires on both cars, but I noticed right away as a driver, I don't know about passenger, that's Denise, but as a driver, the ride is much harsher. It's not smooth. It's not to say that the ride is smoother than the Model X with the 22s. It's not, but it's smoother than this.
Yeah, it's not as smooth as the Model X.
Okay, and then now cornering, this thing corners like it's on rails, it's lighter, it's like 1,000 pounds lighter, you feel it, it's more like a go-kart, it's more like a lifted Model 3, it feels like that when I drive it,
it's
you know?
It's more nimble.
Yeah, more nimble, shorter wheelbase, I think the whole thing's shorter, and it's not as wide, so it's narrower. So it has a comparable amount of space, but like when we're car camping in the back, we have our cooler and the mattress, we can tell it's. I can't turn around at night, right? Because
yeah.
There's not as much width.
There's not as much elbow room, but there's more headroom.
There's right? more. That's right. There is. That's the one positive. And now there's no falcon wing doors in this. So in terms of getting in and out normally, you know, there's no rain shield when you're normally getting in and out. But then when Denise gets in and out of the bed, when we have car camping, at first you said it was harder to get in and out.
Yeah, it's much more difficult. Yeah.
It still is?
It's easier to get in and out of if you're just sitting in the back seat. But if you're trying to get into a prone position, yeah, it's much more difficult with this little car.
Okay. Now, what else? Of course, this car is like half the price of the Model X, okay? This car is around $40,000 base, and then Model X is around $80,000 base. So you have to decide what you're gonna do. Nobody has free supercharging anymore like we do. We have to pay for this, okay? So I've noticed that it's kind of pricey actually in terms of what it is. We'll get the final bill from Hertz because this is through Hertz renting. They charge automatically to my credit card through my Hertz rental. Okay, that's how it works. And I can still see it on the app. But we noticed air conditioning issues. I've noticed this before. Join Tesla High Mileage Club at teslahighmileageclub.com to learn more. Look at the featured posts. But you need to clean out that front radiator / condenser on your air conditioning unit because it's constantly using it during supercharging. Of course, this has no extra tinted windows. It's got the ones from the factory, but ours is extra. So this thing has a very hard time when we're in more northern Florida now. This is Rosemary Beach where we are, but we were down in Naples. It was having a really hard time. I mean, this thing was howling, this fan, okay? And I knew right away, at first I couldn't figure out the vent system because it's kind of quirky the way the whole thing works. I finally figured it out and got better, but it's still running at super high speed way more often than it should and struggling at times when it's super sunny, okay, and hot. And it shouldn't do that. That's an indication that nobody's been cleaning the system. So it's 2022, it's almost 3 years old. It needs to be done every year. And we are hearing compressor noises too, which I recorded on separate short videos. And I'm pretty sure the compressor bearings are bad now because it's been struggling too much. Like, it never should have to go into overdrive like that unless it's on a super high, like 250 kilowatt charge. And we've noticed that too, because compared to the older X, it will charge 250 kilowatts. I've seen that. Ours only does like 170, 175 is the most I've seen. So it's faster on the supercharges, but that air conditioner is shot in this thing. And that's true with any Tesla, because you've got the frunk, so they put, you know, instead of the radiator condenser going up and down where you can shoot water through it, it's down flat. And you got to tear it, the whole frunk out, and you got to clean it. And they say no maintenance. They say you don't need to do it, but I'm telling you, you do. And we're seeing here on the Hertz rental, everything else is flawless with the car, I'd say, with the way it runs, which is surprising because it's a rental. It's been a rental for over 100,000 miles. But that is just deferred, neglected maintenance, and it's suffering because of that. So it's not particular to this model. It's particular to any Tesla, any electric vehicle. You've got to maintain, meaning flush out, clean out those radiator slash condensers on the air conditioning compressors. It's not like a regular fuel car.
It's an all afternoon job if you do it yourself. My test video's on it.
Yeah, go to TeslaHighMileageClub.com. All right, what else can we tell you about?
This one has the optional premium sound.
Oh, actually, it does not. It does not. We were talking about that earlier. Yeah, it has a subwoofer, but I believe that at this point in time, all Teslas have subwoofers. When I ordered mine, it was an extra charge. I didn't pay for it. It was like $500. But I do believe that almost all Teslas, except for maybe the lower base models, but even the base models, they may have it now.
It sounds so better with it.
Yeah, but I also redid the EQ. You have to go in there and redo the EQ, and I did, because most people don't know how to adjust it. So yeah, Denise likes it, but that's not the slate. It's not unique to this model, any newer Tesla, and this is 5 years newer than what we have, you know, so there's that. But so the front frunk has a lot of room, but not as much as Model X. There's no question, I don't know if you looked in there, but there's way more room in Model X frunk. There's some nice pockets in the back of the hatch over here on the sides that hold our laptops and things. They're actually pretty big. And you know, this is a five-seater, ours is a five-seater, so we're comparing apples to apples because there's different seating configurations. So we're comparing five-seater Model X to five-seater Model Y, and neither one, especially, I don't know how they, we've gotten the Model Y, check our channel for the video, when they introduced the Model Y, that was in 2019, so that was almost 6 years ago. We rode in the back of one, I think we were in the third row. But they don't. It seems like they don't really sell many of them, and I'm really concerned actually about crash tests in the back, because the back crumples, and it'll crumple right into you. It'll crumple you to death actually if you're riding back there.
You didn't talk about the autopilot differences. Oh. It doesn't change lanes.
Okay, well this doesn't have the full autopilot. Ours, we pay for the full autopilot. I'm now noticing the difference between base and not. It's interesting because the turn signals, I can just push down halfway and it'll blink, and it knows when I got into that lane, but I'm still having the habit of turning it back off. And then it turns, it hits the blinker in the other direction. It freaks everybody out behind me. But yeah, this is base autopilot, so it has that camera in the cabin. Ours does not have the camera in the cabin, versus an older Model X. And that thing really knows when I'm looking at the phone or distracted, and it locks me out. It complains. That's a big difference. I mean, I can't really do as many things as I was doing. Yeah, it's still driver assistance in either way. But this, like Denise said, it won't change lanes. It doesn't respond well to speed limit changes. There's a lot of things it doesn't do.
It doesn't exit when you want.
Right. It doesn't. It's only like a glorified traffic aware cruise control that keeps you in your lane. That's what it is.
You've missed your exit a couple of times. That's
yes. Yes. And that's not a Tesla. I don't know what that is.
No, it's a Harley.
I don't know about a Harley, but maybe just, well, probably won't hear it anymore. All right, what else can we say about the differences? Everything's in the center screen. We have the old one with the screen that's a portrait. And I'm noticing, and I don't know if the newer X's are like this, but there's a lot less total information that's displayed on the screen. Like on ours, I can see, and there's a second screen on ours. That may be why. The second screen in front of the driver. I'm not used to that at night because at night I see nothing in front of me. I have to look over to the side. And then if I look over to the side, then the camera gets mad at me. So it's kind of weird the way that they do that. There's no in front screen. So if they had enough information, I would be better with it. Because I can see like street view of like when I'm going to make my turn, and I can see wide view, and I can see rear view camera all at the same time in our car. This, I can't do that. I'm very limited. So that's another reason why I've missed turns, is because I wasn't exactly sure where that turn was, because it won't show me the wide out view and the close in view at the same time. And I can't see it out of my back's camera at the same time. So I don't, I can look at the rearview mirror, okay, and our window's blacked out like a Cybertruck, kind of like when the cover's over. But even so, I still can't show all those views at the same time in this one. So if that matters to you, it may be worth the extra difference.
Sorry, you don't have live traffic updates, too.
Oh, yeah. That's right. The roads that we found on this, I don't know if it's something you have to pay for data. Maybe we're grandfathered in and we get that data. But yeah, I can't see. I have to open my phone up to look at the traffic data because I can't figure out any way to show traffic data on the main screen.
So if you're trying to avoid an accident or something, or there's a big slowdown, you have no idea where the car's going to take you.
Yeah, and by the way, this is the best-selling car in the world. It has been for a few years now, and they're going to come out with the new one, the Juniper, I think, which will be redesigned kind of like Model 3 just came out. It's just more of a cosmetic refresh and a refinement refresh, and maybe the ride will be better. I don't know. But for now, there's definitely a difference in X and Y. Is it worth twice the price? I don't think so. Okay, I think that's why this is the best-selling car in the world. But this thing has so many things well. It's like your purse. It's like I feel it's like almost like my little driving pod. And I see because we're in Florida, a lot of golf carts going by. I'm like, this is so much better than a golf cart. It's not that much bigger than a golf cart because it is smaller than ours, you know. But it does so many things better, and it won't roll over. It you'll survive in a crash. It has, you know, collision avoidance stuff all over the place. So it's, you know, yeah, I can see as long as they keep the price low. Like we saw some of these electric golf carts. They're close to, they're more like $15,000+.
This car's okay? Like four times the size of my golf cart. I don't know why you're comparing.
Well, it's not that. Some of these golf carts are pretty big, but I'm just saying price wise. If you can get this for 40 plus an $8,000 rebate, and you get a finance at a really low rate compared to like these other golf carts, they're becoming. They got windows that roll up, they got air conditioning, but none of that stuff works as well as it does in this car.
And I get like 20 grand.
Yeah, but that's still for what you get for what you pay. I can see why this is one of the best-selling car in the world. Apparently, it might actually outsell Ford F-150, which is the best-selling vehicle in the United States, which is actually a truck, but it may surpass it this year, 2024, or maybe 2025. So that's, let's see, what else can we say? Because, so the difference is, what would you choose? What are your top pluses and minuses of this vehicle compared to Model X? Are you looking forward to getting back in the Model X? We're going to get it back tomorrow or the next day.
I like the Model X being driven around in it by him, but if I were to choose my own car, I would probably go with a Y, just because I have to park in tight spaces at the office.
It's easier to maneuver. It's definitely easier to maneuver. that's a thing. And actually, well, I will also say that this hood goes down fast. You're at such a high up position, you can't really see this hood at all, but you really can't see it on the Model X either. I think it kind of just goes out of the way. So anyway, we got to get out of the street, mm-hmm. I think. So I think we're done anyway, right?
Yep. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, let us know if you have any
subscribe.
Yeah, and let us know if you have any comments. Just comment down below. And we'll see you in the next video.